Alright, so this is a quick demonstration of independent samples t-test and bivariate correlation. A student researcher reached out to me and said that she watched my videos, very nice and helpful, but she is having some difficulties with running t-tests, she says. In fact, she says she can't run any test. The output tables appear incorrect and unusable. She looked at the issue together with her coach, but could not seem to figure out exactly what was the problem. And in terms of analysis, she says she wants to figure out if there are differences between Gen X and Gen Y respondents, and she wants to find some correlations among the variables she measured. She sent me her data file, so let's take a look together. Now, this is her SPSS data. I don't know the details of her study. I haven't seen her survey either. Let's just focus on the data file here. Everything seems just fine. A sample size of 118. Variable names. Everything is numeric. All right, so let's just give it a try. We're gonna try to do some t-tests and correlations. That's what she wanted to do, so we're gonna give it a go and see what comes out. Let's start with some t-tests. Compare means, independent samples t-test. Oh, by the way, we need to see where her vary. Okay, so she has a gen 1 and 2 for X and Y. Great. So we're analyze compare means, independent sample t-test. I'm just going to grab a bunch of variables and then grouping variable Gen X and Gen Y, she coded 1 and 2. Okay. All right, let's see. Social media. All right, that does seem a little strange. So let's go back to the data. All right, I think her labels are pretty redundant. I'll just delete these labels. All right. So let's remove the labels, and now we run the t-tests again. Now everything seems to work just fine. We see that there are indeed some variables which show significant differences between Gen X and Gen Y. For example, social media 4. Whatever that item is. So social media 4, we see Gen X 2.3, Gen Y 2.8, and that is a statistically significant difference according to the t-test. All right, so I think that is the, maybe that was the problem that was causing her confusion, the labels that she used. Let's do a correlation. We're just gonna grab a bunch of variables. And correlation seems to work just fine. There isn't anything that comes out as too strange. All right, so I think that's it. I think her issue simply was the fact that her labels were a bit confusing. So in this case, it is simply better to run the analysis on the variable names instead of the label, and then everything is just fine. As I said, I don't really know any details about this research project, so I will not comment on any other aspects of her data. Responding specifically to her questions regarding running the t-test and the correlations, everything should work just fine now. All right, so good luck to you and success with your project.